We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Battlepug Issue 1 from Image Comics from 2019. This is written by Mike Norton, art by Alan Passalaqua, and Crank did the lettering. I think Norton also did some art. I'm not sure. They don't really have a proper credits page on here. Alright, so the premise is that there's a barbarian and he has a Battlepug, which is this super adorable puppy that we see on the cover. He's also got this friend Molly, who has two dogs, Colfax and Mingo. Both those dogs can talk, the big silly one can't. Now, I thought they were going to do a proper introduction to the characters, but they really don't do that. We kind of jump in the middle. Apparently, there's a compugdium, get it, that collects a bunch of the web comics on one into one volume, and that is being sold through Dark Horse. I didn't know this was a web series. I didn't know anything about this. I bought it because I thought the cover was funny. And apparently, I'm also the only person at my comic shop to have ordered this title. So I guess there's that. And I thought, all right, well, it gives you this intro thing over the course of like 3 or 4 pages that kind of summarizes what happened previously in the compugdium. But I thought that was a much more interesting sounding story because it hadn't really told me anything up to this point. Either just cut that out of the book itself or jump right into the action and fill me in as you go. But they're going to some small town where there is an obvious Putin pastiche and he's got a little puppet with orange hair and orangish skin, so obviously it's a Trump reference, which was incredibly lazily written. The Putin thing, he's got a sickle, of course, it's really dumb. There's some cutesy parts, but then we get this kid that swears a lot. And she names the dog Sir Sprinkles Good Sniffer Von Wigglebottom. And the barbarian guy doesn't much care for that. Then we meet a couple other characters. It turns out this Conan generic barbarian guy may have been a slave of Santa Claus at one point. And that leads into the storyline, which is War on Christmas. Overall, I thought the main story was much better than this little backup story. The backup story was kind of stupid. I didn't care about that at all. It was just dumb. The primary story was okay. The Trump thing was really stupid, but it had its moments. Was it worth $4? Absolutely not. This was maybe $1.50 good. Probably not even that good. It has potential, though. The comedy pacing is pretty good. Some of the jokes are pretty funny. The little kid that swears a lot, yeah, that was edgy back in 1996, but since then, not really. Kind of lazy on that front. It's outdated humor at best and kind of trite at worst. A barbarian riding a pug into battle? That's funny. The barbarian's got some pretty good jokes. The female sidekick is clearly smarter than him, which is really obnoxious and kind of a little too much modern era comics for me. I probably won't read issue 2. Thought it had potential, but I don't think that that potential is going to even be remotely realized in this. Norton obviously has a pretty good sense of humor, but most of the jokes seem to be outdated stuff or politics driven, which is really, really lazy. That might work on your stupid web comic, but in the comics mainstream, that's not a huge seller. As we've noticed with a lot of the declining sales of books, people don't want blatantly obvious politics in their mainstream titles. So this will be either regulated to the indies market or it'll collapse within a fairly short period. But if it gets funnier, maybe it's got a chance. But I'm not going to recommend this one. I thought it was overall a miss. The cover's funny, but it's not worth picking up just for the cover. So if you're looking to pick this up, get it out of a quarter box. That's about the best you can hope for entertainment value. That's just my take. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.